В этом уроке Дэн Рассел рассказывает о том, как искать текст на веб-странице. Урок посвящен использованию сочетания клавиш Ctrl-F, чтобы найти слово на странице, и расположение поисковых окон в различных браузерах. Это бывает очень полезно, когда текст веб-страницы очень значительный по объему, и нужно найти, есть ли слово в этом тексте.
Suppose you run in a local 8K race. I ran in one recently, and I want to find my time on that page. Here's what the page looks like. It's just a long, long list of people and their running times, and it goes on forever. So how do I find my time? Because looking through this line by line is going to be very slow, and it's going to be fraught with errors. It's going to be the kind of thing you mess up.
So how can I... Одним из вариантов является сочетание клавиш Ctrl-F на клавиатуре. Вы можете попробовать Ctrl-F на любой веб-странице.
In all browsers, you can do either Command-F, if you're on a Macintosh, or a Control-F, if you're on a PC or a PC equivalent. In both cases, you do this kind of funny two-finger strike. You hold down the Command key and then type F, or hold down the Control key and then type F at the same time. In both cases, that will bring up a search box that allows you to search through that text, finding the text you're looking for. So, here's an example. Here's that long text document I was talking about earlier, the results from the 8K race. Here we are. This is the race page. What I'm going to do is type Command-F, because I'm on a Macintosh, running Chrome. Command-F, and you see this thing that pops up here? That was the previous search, so I'm going to go back. This is the page we want to search for. This is that page of all the results. So what I'm going to do, since I'm on a Macintosh, is type Command-F. Watch this. Command-F, and the box appears in the upper right corner. So now I'm going to type in my name, R-U-S-S-E-L-L, and notice it's not case sensitive here. And if you look carefully, you'll see that this is one of four. So let's go down and find the highlighted text. And there it is, Russell. Notice that the case is not the same, but that's all right. This is case insensitive. Now that's not me, I'm Dan. That's my son, as it turns out. So what I'm going to do is click on this down arrow or hit enter. It does the same thing. It goes to the next found text. In this case, I'm going to hit enter, return, and it finds my name, as you can see, Daniel Russell, and this is my entry here. And that's my time. So notice, though, that it says up here that there are four hits on this text, Russell, in this document. So I can use these arrows to go down to the next one, which is now in an age bracket group for my son, or a different age bracket group for me. And so now we see all the different instances of the term that we're looking for.
Где именно находится окно поиска, меняется в зависимости от того, какой браузер вы будете использовать. В Firefox в левом нижнем углу экрана.
Firefox, the find box will appear in the lower left corner, way down here. Now you see, just like in Chrome, you've got the up to go to the previous instance and down to go to the next instance on the page. Basically, you move up, move down to each of that instances of the text you're looking for. You can also click on this highlight all button to automatically highlight all of the instances on the page.
В Safari, в верхнем правом углу экрана.
If you're using Safari,
the find box appears in the upper right. You can see this here. Again, they can go forward or back. That's what the left and right arrows are. It tells you how many matches you have.
В Google Chrome, в верхнем правом углу экрана.
We've got some results. We can go up and down. It tells you the total number of instances found.
В Internet Explorer, в левом верхнем углу экрана.
In the lower left, upper left, upper right. Pay attention to your browser. You need to know what your browser does in this case. But in Internet Explorer 9, it appears in the upper left corner. Again, they have previous and next to go forward and back in the document, total number of matches, and different options, including the option to match the case. So, as I showed you in Chrome, I had case insensitive. Here you could turn case sensitivity on if you wanted to. Here I'm on the
Wikipedia page. Далее приводятся примеры.
Athletics
events. And what I'm curious about is to find how did Usain Bolt do? So what I'm going to do is type Command F, and you see the thing popped up there, and I'm going to type the name Usain because that's an unusual name. And you can see here we already know we have 8 instances of the word Usain on this page. And if you look in the right hand side, you see the little yellow bars there and the scroll bar. You can see all 8 positions in the long document where this word occurs. So you can see over here, the browser has highlighted his name. And if we skip down a little bit, I'm going to scroll up. Now you see the scroll bar appear, and I'm going to move it down to the next group of instances. And there we go. We have 3 instances of Usain Bolt's name, 1, 2, 3, corresponding to these 3 yellow lines in the scroll bar. This is nice because you can now see how those terms appear throughout the entire document. That's sometimes a really handy thing to know.
Почему вы должны это знать? Основная причина в том, что это действительно помогает быстрее находить то, что вы ищете.
Page really speeds up your search. In our studies, we found that it speeds up the rate at which people search by roughly 12%, and that's a huge amount of time. It's like giving you 12% of your life back.
Далее Дэн Рассел говорит, что в исследовании Google обнаружено, что этот прием сокращает время поиска на 12%. А когда проводили это исследование, обнаружилось, что только 10% пользователей знали об использовании сочетания клавиш Ctrl+F.
You'll be faster, and we also know from other studies you're going to be more accurate and more efficient overall. Now, the last property is kind of the neatest one of all, because it will tell you, using this Ctrl+F, Command+F trick, whether or not a word appears on the document or not. Think about that. You can actually prove that something is not on the document. That's a rare skill, a rare ability.
Пожалуйста, используйте этот прием. Попробуйте функцию в своем поиске.
For example, a person never ran in that race, or at least was never recorded. You search for their name in that 8K running race list. They're not there, they didn't run, or they were never written down by the race recorders. This overall trick is really handy to know, and I need you to have this in your toolbox. So going forward, this is the end of the first set of lessons for class number 1. We're looking forward to class number 2, where we will learn not just how to make queries, but how to interpret the results and understand what it is that we're doing.